I'm giving somebody the blues today.
Jin and Xiaoyu's relationship is very similar to Kazuya's and Jun Kazama's relationship because they have a really strong bond with one another. In Tekken Bloodline, we are shown the deep relationship between Jin and Xiaoyu for what feels like the first time ever. We can see not only them two laughing, interacting with one another, but also them walking to school with each other. These scenes explain a lot. It shows us how their deep connection, their relationship, grew. Xiaoyu witnesses each and every day the pain that Jin goes through while training with Heihachi. He's so engulfed with the hatred of taking down Ogre, Heihachi is fueling that.
You hesitated. Hesitation is a weakness, and most likely what killed your mother. You will never beat Ogre with hesitation.
But what it shows us as the viewer is why Xiaoyu feels like she has to save him. Because at this point, Jin is too engulfed with the madness, with the chaos. He only sees the destination, which is taking down Ogre. But he's not thinking about what Heihachi's trying to gain out of this. He's not thinking about how Xiaoyu's affected, how he's affected. But once they do defeat Ogre, and Jin is betrayed by Heihachi, he goes full sicko mode. This is the point where I feel like Xiaoyu's hearts break. She was with Jin throughout all of this, but she failed, and also Harang. Everyone failed. Heihachi just had too much of control over Jin, and Jin was just focusing too much on Ogre. So he hit rock bottom. His perception of the world was distorted, and he really wasn't thinking clearly. And as a result of that, he became a monster. And what is so sad about this is Xiaoyu was basically searching for Jin ever since. She was trying to find him and have that conversation with him that she was never able to or never could before. She was trying to fix the wrongs of the past. While chasing Jin all over the globe, Xiaoyu gets herself into a lot of trouble. In one of those instances, she is rescued by Yoshi, who explains the whole entire Mishima story to her. When Heihachi pushed Kazuya down the mountain, the Devil Gene, all of it. He explained everything he knew. Soon after that, Heihachi died. I don't know if guilt is the correct word to use, but the reason why she feels so much regret and guilt is because she was there. Keep in mind, Jin Kazama was being trained by Heihachi for many, many years. Ogre attacked when Jin was 15. Ogre was defeated when Jin was 19. That is 4 years that Jin and Xiaoyu were walking to school. Jin was showing up all bruised and broken. Xiaoyu witnessed all of it. That is why she's trying to not only save Jin, but also Heihachi. When Heihachi dies, when Jin goes missing, all of that stuff, she feels like she could have done something to help them. But canonically, Xiaoyu was not able to reach Jin in Tekken 5, 6, or the little parts of Tekken 7 where the tournament did exist. She was not able to reach him. But in Tekken Blood Vintage, she was able to speak to Jin on a few occasions.
If people only understand each other when they're fighting, then tell me, how did you and I become friends?
Hatred can be suppressed with reason.
Control your anger. Don't let it control you.
But you must give into it at times, or it will eat you alive.
Can't believe you feel that way.
And the way that Jin is talking in this moment, you could just tell how lost he is. This guy is in his full devil form, and it's like he's not even human. You can just see how removed from humanity he is.
Only humans can stop their own destruction.
It's a clear contrast between Xiaoyu, humanity, and then Jin, like a demon.
I will be challenged again someday. It could be by someone more powerful, or it could even be you. Either way, I'll be waiting for it.
Jin.
As he's saying this, look at how Xiaoyu is reacting in the moment. She is just like heartbroken, crushed.
Humans should just... should just disappear! Xiaoyu, stop it. Don't say that.
She spent years trying to find Jin, but the Jin that she ends up finding is not the one that she lost. Who knows if he's that same person? Who knows if he is savable? Which is why I think Jin says what he says. He says, one day I will be challenged. It may even be you, Xiaoyu. You may be the one who comes hunt me down and try to stop me. And if you think about everything that he did in Tekken 6, all of the chaos and destruction, it makes sense. Because yes, Xiaoyu loves Jin, but also she loves humanity, the world. There was one point in Tekken Blood Vengeance where she said that humans shouldn't exist or something like that. And you could just see how much of a toll all of this is taking on her. And you could just see how hard it is for her to continue through this. And I feel like at a certain point, all of that sadness and sorrow will probably be directed at Jin Kazama. He can see what he's doing. He's not dumb. He's not blind. He's just like lost. He can see the damage that he's causing to Xiaoyu, which is why he understands that he will be targeted by her one day, because he's not stopping and she's not gonna stop.
I know that one day you will come to defeat me and I'll be waiting.
I wanna draw a comparison to Jun and Kazuya. Jun Kazama is not fighting Kazuya Mishima because she wants to kill him and, you know, let's finish what Heihachi started. No, she is fighting Kazuya because she wants to save him. If you look at what she says in her character ending or whatever, it says, "Let me be your solace." She's trying to help him. But for the Mishimas, it seems like the only way you can truly help them is first if you break them down, if you take away, because their first instinct is to fight. So you have to break down their will to fight. You have to beat them physically. And then once you do that, then you could try to reason with them, or then you could try to do this or that. So that's kind of what Xiaoyu and Jun Kazama has to go through. The Mishimas are just too hard-headed, and power is all they see. Power is everything. So you have to remove power from the equation physically, like forcefully, and then you can try to go the other route. And Jin knows this, Jun knows this, Kazuya knows this, and Xiaoyu will soon realize it. I think that's very interesting. Xiaoyu will eventually have to do the same thing that Jun is doing to Kazuya right now. But the only thing that could prevent this is also Jun Kazama, because she's not only trying to save Kazuya, but also Jin. So Xiaoyu may not be the one who have to face Jin. Jun Kazama may also do that as well. You know, thank you that Mommy Jun is back, because she is fixing a lot of what's broken about the Mishima clan, and Xiaoyu may just be a benefactor of that. But going back to the canon now, Xiaoyu doesn't find Jin in Tekken 7, but instead she finds Claudio. I don't know if I would classify him as evil or devious, but he's definitely using her as bait. You know, let's save Jin, we could do this together. She's following Claudio to all of these different locations. Even though his name wasn't mentioned in her bio, it's still said that she is traveling all across the globe. And in the Pachinko slot machine, what do we see? That exact thing. They're traveling through cities, through forests, through libraries. They're traveling all over. And Claudio is the one who's basically pulling all the strings. Xiaoyu is just there because she cares about Jin. And also, you can say the same thing about Jin Kazama. Even though he is lost, he still cares about her. Because another thing too, like in canon or non-canon, Jin does try to protect Xiaoyu. Even while he's rampaging, once he does face Claudio, he is rampaging in a devil form, and it's not necessarily Jin Kazama who's in control, it's Devil Jin. But even when Xiaoyu steps in front of Claudio, what does Jin do? Instead of just slicing right through her to get to Claudio, he stops himself. You can see with every fiber of his body, he will not lay a finger on Xiaoyu. Even though he is lost, he is not so much lost to where he is just tearing down the person he cares so much about.
Don't let hatred turn you into a monster!
But I am a monster. It's all that's left.
You're wrong. Can't you understand? All this fighting is pointless. It's never gonna end!
It will end with this bloodline. And that is why I fight.